Use the excess material to mold it into handles. Ensure that there's no air trapped. Posterior handles is 8 to 10 millimeters in height and length, and the width is 5 millimeters. The anterior handle is 10 millimeters in height and 20 millimeters forward at a 45 to 60 degree angle. When placing the handles, make sure that you place it in the correct position in the molar region. You can apply a bit of pressure on this handle to allow for molding where the joint is. Mold the handle to the tray. Be careful not to apply too much pressure. Ensure that the two posterior handles are aligned. For the anterior handle, the length is 2 to 3 centimeters. Once molded to the center of the ridge anteriorly, you can form the shape 1 centimeter up and then at a 60 or 45 degree angle forward. In the case of a very resorbed ridge, you would have your anterior handle higher than 1 centimeter before it goes forward out of the mouth. Ensure that the anterior handle is right in the center.
The lacquer material is sticky and can be wiped with the liquid provided by the manufacturers or with Vaseline. Use a little Vaseline on your fingers and smoothen the edges of the handles to the rest of the tray before curing the tray. When curing the tray, it goes into a light cure machine. When placing the tray in the light curing unit, ensure that the handle is supported at the correct angle. The same applies for the upper tray. When placing the excess material in these top areas, ensure that it is slightly above the wax spacer. Gradually adapt it over the ridge. In the stops area, you can apply some pressure to ensure that the stops are molded to the wafer. Adapt the wafer right into the deepest part of the sulcus. Apply more pressure over the stop areas. Cut the excess off to the deepest part of the sulcus. Posterior handles are in the molar region.